concentrated H2SO4, it can give esters. So this process of formation of ester is known as esterification. Okay. So here I have taken the structure of phenol, that is AROH. Now it is reacting with carboxylic acid, that is RC4OH. Okay, carboxylic acid I have taken. Now these two undergo reaction in presence of concentrated H2SO4. And it loses water molecule. So hydrogen from phenol, OH from acid, eliminates as H2O. Now the remaining part, RCO, is added to this oxygen, converts into ester. Okay, here already oxygen is present. Now another CO is added, which is again containing R. So this is nothing but ester. So ester general representation RCO4R. Now it is in the form of RCO4R. Whereas one R group is replaced by aromatic ring, then we can say it is aromatic esters. Okay. So this is one of the chemical property, that is esterification. Now we'll see about the next chemical property, that is electrophilic substitution reaction. So even phenols can participate in electrophilic substitution reaction because during the formation of resonating structures at R2 and para positions, the phenol ring is containing electron-rich density. So the electrophile is going to attack and that electrophile is replaced by another electrophile. So it is known as electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay. So now one of the example of electrophilic substitution reaction is hydration. Okay, so here one of the electrophile is replaced by another electrophile, that is nothing but NO2. So substitution of NO2 group is known as nitration. Okay, so this nitration will take place on phenol. So now I am taking here phenol. Okay, so here two types of nitrations will take place. If suppose nitration is taking place in presence of dilute HNO3. So here I am taking nitric acid, that is HNO3, which is in dilute formation. Okay, so then here we will get a mixture of two compounds. See here, this is containing two ions. HNO3 contains two ions, that is NO2 plus OH minus. Okay, so an oxygen and hydrogen can exist as OH minus, another two oxygens and hydrogen can exist as NO2 plus. Now it is bearing positive charge, so that we can say it is as an electrophile. And here at ortho position and para position. So this is ortho. Why it is ortho? Functional group carbon, adjacent carbon is known as ortho carbon. Okay. Ortho carbon, adjacent carbon, meta. Meta adjacent position is known as para. Even this is ortho because functional group carbon, adjacent carbon. So it is ortho, next to that meta, next to that is para. Now at ortho and para positions, hydrogens are present. Okay. So this hydrogen, whatever is present at ortho position, that is replaced by NO2. Okay. So if it is replacing ortho hydrogen, we will get one product, that is phenol ring with ortho position and NO2 group. Okay, then it is known as 2-nitro. This is the first position and it becomes the second position. At second position, NO2 group is present, we can call it as 2-nitrophenol. Okay, and one more chance is there, even at para position, we can see electron rich density. So that the coming electrophile can also replace the hydrogen present at the para position. So if this NO2 replaces this hydrogen, we will get another product with the phenol ring and NO2 group is located at para position. Okay, then it is known as 4. So this is the first position, next the second, this is third carbon, fourth. Now at fourth carbon, NO2 group is present, it is known as 4-nitrophenol. Okay, see here. This is the nitration in presence of dilute HNO3. So in presence of dilute nitric acid, when phenol undergo nitration, it leads to give a mixture of 2-nitrophenol and 4-nitrophenol. So these two can be separated by using here that can make intramolecular, that means within the molecule it will make hydrogen bond. See, this NO2 we can also write it as NO double bond O. Okay, OH we can separate as O1H. So these two groups are adjacent with each other. Then oxygen of nitrogen can attract the hydrogen of OH group and will make some attractive forces. And this attractive force is known as hydrogen bond. So this hydrogen bond is present within the same molecule. So we can call it as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay? Due to containing intramolecular hydrogen bonding, two nitrophenol is steam polar type. That means it gets evaporates on heating. Okay? Now see, four nitrophenol. In this four nitrophenol, these two bulk groups are present for what to each other. That means there is no connection between these two. So that it will not participate in intramolecular hydrogen bond, but it can participate in intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That means whenever another mole of four nitrophenol, even this is four nitrophenol, here NO2 and your OH group is present. Okay, even it is 1, 2, 3, 4 nitrophenol. So when another mole of 4 nitrophenol come closer to the first molecule, oxygen of this nitrogen is attracting this hydrogen of first molecule. Okay, again now some attractive forces are formed. Now these attractive forces are between two different molecules, so that we can say it as containing intermolecular hydrogen. Okay, so due to having intermolecular hydrogen bond, it is highly stable, so that it cannot undergo volatilization. Okay, that means it is stable compound, it is less stable and gets evaporate when it is on heating. That means if a beaker is containing both 2 nitrophenol and 4 nitrophenol on heating, only this 2 nitrophenol gets evaporate and the liquid contains only 4 nitrophenol. So that by using steam distillation we can separate these. Okay, that means on reacting with dilute HNO3, it gives a mixture of 2 nitrophenol and 4 nitrophenol. Now, if the same migration takes place in presence of concentrated HNO3. Okay, migration in concentrated HNO3. Okay, same phenol I am taking here. When this phenol undergo reaction with concentrated HNO3, that means many moles of HNO3 will be present. At a time, all the ortho, this is ortho hydrogen, even this is ortho hydrogen, and this is para hydrogen. At a time, all the three hydrogens are replaced by NO3 groups. For example, here I have taken three moles of concentrated HNO3. Okay, it will be containing three moles of NO2+, okay, and three moles of OH-. So these three NO2+ electrophiles at a time can replace these three hydrogens. That can give a compound, only one compound containing NO2 groups at ortho and para positions. Okay, so three nitro groups are located at ortho and para positions. Finally, we got here 2, 4, 6, 5 nitrophenol. Okay, this is first position, second position, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now nitro groups are present at second, fourth, and sixth. So that it is known as 2, 4, 6, 5 nitrophenol. So this 2, 4, 6, 5 nitrophenol is also known as picric acid. Okay, this is very important for 1 mark. So what is IUPAC name of picric acid? That is 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. Okay, on reaction with concentrated HNO3, it can give 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. On reaction with dilute HNO3, it can give a mixture of 2 nitrophenol and 4 nitrophenol. And next electrophilic reaction is halogenation. Okay, last chemical property of phenol is halogenation. So under this halogenation, we want to see about bromination. Okay, so bromination is nothing but substitution of bromine at Okay. If suppose phenol undergo reaction with bromine water, we will get only one type of compound, that is 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. If suppose the same bromination is taking place in presence of polar solvents such as carbon bisulfide or carbon tetrachloride at 0 degree centigrade temperature. Okay, this is second condition. Bromination to the phenol in presence of polar solvents such as carbon bisulfide and carbon tetrachloride at 0 degree Celsius temperature. Here we will get a mixture of compound, two compounds. That is, in first case, hydrogen present at after position replaced by bromine atom. Okay, then we will get two bromophenol. In the second case, the hydrogen present at para position is replaced by bromine atom. Then we will get here 4-bromophenol. At fourth position, bromine is present. Okay, here we got two compounds, that is 2-bromophenol and 4-bromophenol. So that is about the bromination. So under this bromination, we have studied about the two methods. So if bromine is adding ion in the presence of water, it can give 2,4,6-tribromophenol. If it is taking place in presence of polar solvent, we will get a mixture of 2-bromophenol and 4-bromophenol. So this is about the electrophilic substitution reactions of phenols. So next chemical property of phenol is Colbert's reaction. So this reaction is very important for 2 marks. Listen carefully. Okay, so in Colbert's reaction, first phenol is treated with sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH. Okay, when it is treated with sodium hydroxide, OH group forms this NaOH and hydrogen of phenol together eliminates as H2O. And what is left here? Sodium. So this sodium is going to react with oxygen. Then we will get here sodium phenoxide. Now sodium is added to oxygen. We got sodium phenoxide. Okay. Now this sodium phenoxide undergo reaction with carbon dioxide. So we can write that CO2 as C double bond 4 and C double bond 4. This is carbon dioxide. So before adding the CO2 to the sodium phenoxide, a small rearrangement will take place within the molecule. And see here, at ortho position where hydrogen is present, all the positions will be having hydrogen. And just taking this ortho position hydrogen. So this hydrogen now replaced by sodium atom. Between oxygen and sodium, bond involves in linkage. Sodium completely eliminates as Na plus. Okay? Thereby, whatever the hydrogen present at ortho position, that is going to attack this oxygen atom. So this hydrogen is added to oxygen. That I am completing first. See here, from here sodium is eliminated. In the place of sodium, ortho hydrogen is added. So we know hydrogen always eliminates as H plus. Thereby, this carbon will be having negative charge. Understood? Simultaneously, the pi bond present between the oxygen and carbon moves to oxygen. Then this oxygen gets negative charge, this carbon gets positive charge. Okay? And to this negatively charged oxygen, whatever the sodium is eliminated, that is added. Okay? And will make oxygen-sodium bond. And here, a positive charge is created on the carbon of carbon dioxide, which is added to the negative charge of benzene. That means between these two now bond is created, that I am representing here. Okay, so carbon, now this carbon is attached to oxygen by double bond, and here a single bond is present, that is with oxygen. To this negatively charged oxygen, now sodium is attached. Okay, sodium salt of salicylic acid is obtained. Okay, now this sodium salt of salicylic acid undergo acidification, that is addition of HCl. Okay, when it undergo acidification reaction, the bond between oxygen and sodium breaks. This sodium reacts with Cl of HCl and can eliminate NaCl. Okay, now hydrogen is added to oxygen. Then we will get your final acidic acid. Okay. Now we will see another most important technical property of phenol, which is nothing but primary chemical reaction. So even this is important for 2 months. Okay, Rheinberg-Thiemann reaction. So in this Rheinberg-Thiemann reaction, initially phenol reacts with sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH. So as we know, when NaOH reacts with phenol, it loses H2O. That is OH of sodium hydroxide and nitrogen of phenol together releases H2O, can give the most reactive compound, that is sodium phenoxide. Now sodium is added to oxygen, we will get sodium phenoxide. So this sodium phenoxide is highly reactive due to present in the form of salt. Now again, it is undergoing reaction with chloroform, that is CHCl3. Okay, when it reacts with CHCl3, it eliminates HCl. Okay, CHCl3 chloroform contains 3 chlorine atoms. Among 3 chlorine atoms, okay, we can also write the CHCl3 as CHCl3. Okay, now one chlorine from the chloroform, hydrogen from the after position, together eliminates as HCl. Now what is left? CHCl2. Now the CHCl2 is added to orthocarbon. At orthocarbon, now the CHCl2 is added. So the CHCl2 is an intermediate which is known as chloride. Okay, this intermediate is highly reactive and immediately participates in reaction with 2 poles of NaOH. Okay, immediately it is undergoing reaction with base, that is 2 poles of NaOH. We know this 2 poles of NaOH is containing 2 sodium ions, okay, and 2 OH ions. Understand? So these 2 sodiums react with 2 chlorides, eliminates 2 NaCl. And whatever 2 hydroxy groups are present, that substitute at the position of 2 chlorine atoms. Then we will get here OH, here CH, and here OH and OH. Whatever 2 hydroxy groups present here, those 2 hydroxy groups can replace these 2 chloride atoms, converts into a compound containing CHOH. Okay, on the same carbon atom, 2 OH groups should not present. If it is present, it involves in dehydration, that is removal of water. Hydrogen of 1 OH, OH of another group, together eliminates as H2O. Okay, now after eliminating this H2O, what is that? CHO. Okay, that is nothing but aldehyde function. Okay, this is phenol. And after elimination of H2O, CHO we got. That is known as aldehyde. And the compound